And we are live. It's 9:01 a.m. U.S. Pacific Standard Time, Thursday, February 23rd, 2023. Who is your black friend? Stephen Wiley is your black friend. But who's your best friend? Jesus.
Best friend. Best friend.
Happy Black History Month.
Jesus is my best friend. Best friend. Jesus said he'd always be my best friend. Me and my friends, we really get along fine. I put my trust in them, mostly all the time. But I remember something I learned in Sunday school. The teacher said, was my friend. I thought she was a fool. I was stubborn back then. The Bible sat on the shelf. But then one day I realized I can't do it myself. Now you may have heard of Jesus. He's not make believe, pretend. I can guarantee to you Jesus is my best friend.
Best friend.
Wrap it up.
Best friend.
He said he'd always be my best friend.
Papa. 1988.
Now there are certain people that I like to hang around. They know how to cheer me up when I'm feeling down. But no one is perfect. It's incredible the way your part-time friends can be so undependable.
That's true.
I need someone around 24 hours a day. I want someone to listen just to see them my way. I've got someone who loves me from beginning to end. He's there in all circumstance. He is my best friend.
Best friend.
I will be getting to your calls, guys.
Best friend.
Isn't this nice? Black History
Month. Now, he loves me all the time with no strings attached. His unique loving relationship with me cannot be matched. I talk to him all the time. It's real communication. He listens when I'm happy or when I'm full of frustration. I tell him where I'm at and I never hold back.
Right,
I can be honest with him and that's a matter of fact.
Best friend.
I grew
Jesus
up on this.
Jesus is my best friend.
This is my black history.
Best friend. Best friend.
He said he'd always be my best friend.
Make it in. Please make it in. Stephen Wiley. Is this a Christian two life?
He understands my problem, knows exactly what I'm feeling. He's the only one who can provide immediate healing. He's always watching me. He's got a helping hand to lend. One thing I'm sure of, Jesus is my best friend.
Best friend.
Is he your best friend?
Jesus is my best friend. He said he'd always be my best friend.
This slaps to see you on base. Nice.
He said he'd always be my best friend. He understands my problem, knows exactly what I'm feeling. He's the only one who can provide immediate healing. He's always watching me. He's got a helping hand to lend. One thing I'm sure of, Jesus is my best friend.
Best friend.
Best friend. Jesus is my best friend.
Best friend.
He said he'd always be my best friend.
My favorite part's coming up.
He'd always be my best friend.
Makes Will Smith look like Tupac. I like it.
He said he'd always be my best friend. B-E-S-T-F-R-I-E-N-D. 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 Best friend.
Be the him.
He said he'd always be my best friend.
Me and Jesus stay walking on water.
He said he'd always be my best friend.
The production of this song is 240p. Oh no, Hake. Well, thank you guys very much kindly for bearing with me through that excellent track. I have more where that came from. Guys, we're going to be talking today about our greatest president's trip to Ohio. Geronimo says, I got to hand it to Trump showing up in Ohio. Keeping up the morale would be great if we could trust it. Nice. And we will, the people's president. Also going to talk about Bryson Gray. Speaking of black rappers, black Christian rappers, Bryson Gray put out a tweet that was interesting that I came across. Kind of like to watch what goes on inside of me in reaction to some of these tweets. Gross topic, but I will keep it PG or G. PG. Well, nowadays stuff that's G is probably not good at all. He compares the black crime videos to catch a predator videos, noticing a different race is more predominant in the to catch a predator videos. What a mess, huh? And based Don Lemon is poor based Don Lemon, I use the term loosely, groveling to the women for his job. For his job. What a shame. All that and your calls, if you would like to call in. But anyway, guys, let's get right on with the show!
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la.
Hey guys!
Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La la la. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La la la.
So, how you guys doing? How you guys doing? I am James Hake, and I'm fine. Getting all mixed up. I am wearing my Mount Baldy t-shirt. It is fun. It is excellent. Mount Baldy, California. Elevation 10,064 feet, I assume. 10,000 feet. That's going on 2 miles. It's more than a mile high. Mount Baldy, nice place. Especially in the summer. Winter, it's cold. But, People ski up there. By the way, you can super chat on streamlabs.com/thehakereport, which some of you already are, or you can super chat on buymeacoffee.com/thehakereport. Some of you already have, or brand new Ko-fi. I think it's spelled coffee. ko-fi.com/thehakereport. Or, you know, obviously Rumble or Odyssey. I guess DLive. Yes, DLive. DJ Jean-Paul. DJ Jean-Paul. But not YouTube, because Hake. Maybe because of the flag that I used to be flying. The excellent, beautiful rebel flag that I used to be flying. I say used to because past couple days I have not been flying it. Beautiful Southern flag. Maybe they find that not advertiser friendly, so they ban you from even giving super chats. You find it friendly. It's a friendly rebel flag. Anyway, what a mess. Let me get right to a call here, guys, before I get started on Trump in East Palestine, Texas. Denny is in Bulgaria on the line. How are you doing, Denny? Thanks for calling.
Thank you for having me, Mr. Hake. I hope you're doing well.
I am. I appreciate it. Thank
you. Mr. Hake, I was watching your program yesterday. Remarkable as always. There was a young man, gentleman, called and talked about being in love with a Serbian girl. And it was, I think, at the beginning of the show yesterday.
David in Norway called in saying that he was interested in a Serbian gal who was married in order to stay in the country, I guess.
Right. I think his name was David, but unfortunately I'm very bad with names. My best advice to David is stay away. You have no idea what it's like to be dealing with a Slavic woman. And he described her as blonde and blue-eyed. Those people were crazy. And I didn't go to bad mouth them or anything. And I am Slavic, so yeah, I know what I'm talking about. Those people are so messed up. They've been messed up for millennia.
Really?
Not centuries, for millennia. But yeah, Mr. Hicks, I love history. I study history. Every time a country conquers another country or a tribe, the conquered tribe learns the language of the conqueror. This is why you speak English, because Britain was there, and this is why South America speaks Spanish and Portuguese and so on and so forth.
Right, okay.
Slavic people are the only people that there's no such thing as a Slavic country. Every Slavic country was founded by a tribe from outside of that region.
Whoa.
The Bulgarians came from Asia. The Russians, so-called Russians, Kiska Rus, are Viking tribes, and so on and so on. Those people were never able to form a country because they never had it in them. And not only that, they were so stupid, they were never able to learn any other language. So the conqueror had to learn their language. This is why we have Slavic language.
Oh, my goodness.
Slav itself means, during Roman times, and because they were the main source of slaves,
right.
And Slavio is basically, yeah. They were so, I'm trying to be as polite as possible out of respect for your program.
Okay.
But they were so limited that normally the region was supervised by a centurion or some kind of a governor. But the Slavic region was the only region of the whole Roman Empire that was supervised by another Slavic, because there was no way they could communicate with one another. I'm giving this as a historical example, but things haven't changed that much. And keep in mind that, especially here, the Balkan Peninsula, it's been a troublesome region for a very long time. You know about the war in Ukraine, but there's a war in Serbia as well, between Kosovo and Serbia.
Okay.
There's another war in Turkey. It's an unstable region, and people are frightened. And when they're frightened, they're vicious. And they've been like that for a long time. Not to mention that this region was under the Ottoman control for over 500 years. And later on, when that fell, we had a little bit of an option to generate again. But after all, after that, the USSR invaded, and they killed almost everyone with more than 2 brain cells. So, you know, when you leave only the stupid people and let them reproduce, you can't expect much. So I'm not saying it's hopeless. I'm telling this gentleman that he should be extremely careful with what he's doing, because he has no idea what's going on.
Yeah, because he claimed that this lady seemed very nice. She might be the unicorn of a decent woman who
mm-hmm.
knows how to listen.
Mm-hmm.
But you're saying that's not possible.
Right.
Not likely.
Mr. Hake, we are, and I'm saying we because I'm also Slavic, right? In general, we are tall, we're white, we're good-looking people.
You're Slavic,
we have
too,
well-developed,
you said?
I am Slavic, yes.
Okay.
We have well-developed physique, so we're pleasant to look at.
Okay.
And if we want to, we can be charming. But that doesn't mean that we are decent or anything. Just, you know, if that gentleman is listening, back off.
Okay.
Find a nice Scandinavian girl or something like that and go from there.
And unmarried.
Because
no kids, not married before.
Yeah, that too.
Right.
The Slavic folks are, you just keep, those are, as far as I know, the only people on the planet who willingly embraced communism. Like, how ridiculous can a person be to willingly accept communism and to be happy with it? This
crazy.
Is absurd.
Interesting.
And I didn't go to badmouth the Slavs or anything. I'm just giving it as an example. In 1954, as far as I remember, Bulgaria was under the control of the USSR, and they sent an ambassador to Spain, and he was a shoemaker who graduated second or third grade. He was absolutely illiterate and stupid.
Yeah.
And he was in Spain for 2 years as an ambassador, and he couldn't learn a word of Spanish. So the Spanish people threw him out of the country. They found a Spanish guy who learned Bulgarian in 1 year, and they made him the ambassador.
Interesting.
Imagine the embarrassment. But this is the material. I agree with Mr. Peterson that it's a spiritual issue and this and that. But there's also a genetic material thing, and we shouldn't ignore the data. And the genetic material here is not the best. So I'm wrong. You know, maybe I'm wrong with Hey. Maybe this girl is indeed one of the fine girls or anything. But I've been working mostly in finance and accounting. I deal with numbers. If I have to deal with the numbers here, my best advice is to run away.
Yeah, Geronimo says any quote-unquote lady that he's going to pick up in his current state of mind, which he's like feeling like he's getting along in years, doesn't want to be alone forever like Hake, because he's all, Hake, you're how old are you? And you're still single. And so he's thinking about this particular woman, and he has a crush on her, and she's the only one, and she's special. And she makes the point that it's going to be trouble. Any lady that he picks up in his current state of mind is going to be trouble, not because of the lady alone, not because of the woman itself, but because of his own state of mind. And that's a really good point. He doesn't seem to have the right state of mind, or didn't. Maybe he does now.
Not only that, Mr. Hague, but as far as I know, and of course, I don't know those people personally. I don't know anything.
Yeah.
But as far as I know, if she was married only for the papers, from my point of view, and I take marriage very seriously, I'm the only person from my family who's not divorced.
Nice.
So I take marriage very seriously. And from my perspective, marriage is basically a contract between a man, a woman, and God.
Yeah.
And you cannot bargain with God.
Right.
That's not how it works. And if you're willing to get into marriage because something... Now, I understand that kind of a marriage when in the medieval times when royalty had to marry different other royalties for territory and stuff like that. I understand that. But I'm talking about the regular people.
Yeah.
If you're willing to do something like that, and you basically, in my view, of course, this is my personal view. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. But in my view, this is a betrayal.
I think so. I feel that way too. Even though it was only by the state, it was not, because he says, it was only done in a court, not in a church or something like that. But I totally agree with you.
But here in Europe, it's the opposite. If you do it in the court, it's official. If you do it in the church, it's not official.
Right.
Like, for example, that's how it works here.
Yep.
So this is the official thing. And in all fairness, as far as I know, God doesn't care if you're in a church or in a courthouse.
That's right. Yeah.
Completely different.
Very true.
So
man.
If she was willing, and I don't know her story, I don't know what she went through or is going through, and in all fairness, I don't care. But if you're willing to do something like that for permission to leave your country and go elsewhere, there's a lot of demons in there, and I'd advise the gentleman to stay away.
Yeah, that's selfishness. That's like gaming the system just to so you can stay in this country or that country. It speaks to how bad her country is if she's trying to stay in Norway or something, you know? speaks to your point about the slaves, Slavs.
And I was in the same situation, in all fairness, when
You went to Denmark, right?
Yes, I graduated there. I went to Aalborg University. And when I was a student here, I didn't want to be in Bulgaria. Yeah. And when I went to Denmark, I didn't want to be in Denmark. And I had to realize that the problem was never in Denmark. It was never in Bulgaria.
Right.
I was running away from the thing that was within me.
Yeah.
And you can't self-run it. You just have to beat it.
Good point. Very good point, man. That's deep. How did you get to be so smart and well-adjusted as a Slav, slave? Denny, because you're a Slav.
Honestly,
how did you turn out
know.
So well? You don't know?
I don't know. Maybe I was lucky. I mean, I did have both parents in my household.
But, okay.
You know, most of the Slavs actually do. You know, the divorce rate amongst us is pretty low.
Okay, just not in your family. It's high in your family.
No, I mean, my father was married before, and my mother was married before, and then they met, and they got married, and that's how I came up. I wasn't born out of wedlock.
Okay.
But, you know, that kind of an issue still hits the ground sometimes. But honestly, I don't know. Maybe God just watches over me because I'm trying to be as decent as possible.
Right. Well, man,
and I was,
that's true. There's always a decent one. Go ahead.
Thank you. I was a bit surprised. I didn't know you were 40. I thought you were 30-something. I thought you were 32, 33. So I didn't know you were 40.
Well, I stream it. Do I stream it 720 or do I stream it 1080? But I'm far enough away that my face looks all smooth. But, yeah, I'm going on 42. I'm 41 and a half. When you're that old,
you're aging as a cathedral.
Say again?
You're aging as a cathedral. You've aged well.
I appreciate that, man. Thank you.
With that said, Mr. Hake, I would like to wish kind regards to your colleagues and your viewers. God be with you, and all the best, sir.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it, Denny. Take care.
Bye.
I cut him off there. I'm not sure what he said. He might have said something nice in Bulgarian, which would have been the first time that I know of. But thank you, Denny in Bulgaria. Great call. Take note, David in Norway. We're looking out for you. Or we're trying our best anyway, as your friend of sorts, right? Our best advice. Fellow Christians, I think you're a Christian man. Nice. Let me read a few super chats, and then I'll get into this story, and then I'll get to calls. I do have more calls to get to. There is a line or two open there. On streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport, JohnWX25 says, all you need is dark sunglasses, LA cap, with the opener. Do it for Black History, says JohnWX25. Thank you, man. Happy Black History Month to you, too. We honor it on the Hake Report, but not anywhere else on the JLP network. JLP is all about men's history and White History Month. And I misspoke last time when I mentioned DeGarmo and Key. My middle break song track, that was during Men's History Month that I took off for 3 months. What a mess. What a shame. So much for being a man. Evil is Real says with the super chat, shout out to the low IQ chat. Indeed. Appreciated. Evil is Real called in all perturbed at the flat earthers the other week. That was a fun call and fun reactions. And I'm with Evil is Real on that one. I'm not with him on Paul is a false apostle, though. Or if, you know, whatever. I mean, I don't care whether he's an apostle or not. They call him Apostle Paul, but he says that he didn't really meet Jesus. I disagree with him on that, but it's okay. Lin Yen Chin with a super chat on streamlabs.com/TheHakeReport regarding the, I was speculating it was my flag, my beautiful rebel flag, which I'm not showing right now. I could show it right now. I could. But Lin Yen Chin says, no, Lord Goodhair, it's your mouth that YouTube fears. You speak your mind rather than their script. They don't like this at all. It might reveal too much of what they want to control and destroy. Did you read my breakdown of your condition to the chat? Oh, I did not. I'm going to have to hunt that down, man. You had an excellent comment in one of the comment sections about, basically, I'm kind of like a black. maybe worse. When I speak, my flow is not right because I think of something else to say and I interrupt myself and it causes, maybe, I don't know if that's causing stuttering, but it's kind of choppy, hard to listen to for some, frustrating to listen to for others. I go off on rabbit trails, also known as tangents. And other things is vaguely what I recall him saying. But thank you, Lin Yen Chin. I shall hunt that down. Man, appreciate that, man. And the support and the feedback, as always. Your Danos with the super chat on streamlabs.com/thehakereport. So, Samson. She calls me Samson because I called her Delilah because she asks me personal questions. And I'm not supposed to share, like Samson, my weakness is the way to make me weak. Samson, are you ever going to do Earl's call clips in memory of Earl? Anybody wants to, they're welcome to. I had no intention of doing that, although not that it's a bad idea. It's a great idea. It would be very entertaining. My views would go up, up, up. Blacks are very entertaining, and blacks call my show. Even blacks who don't like Hake so much, or disagree with Hake anyway. Delilah opening up a barber shop today? I cut my own hair, but thank you. Appreciate it. I shall check the co-fees and buy me a coffee and stuff like that. No new ones over there right now. That's cool. Check Rumble. What's up, guys? Odyssey crew. Nice. Geronimo says, Mr. Danny, or Denny, really. It's Denny, D-E-N-N-Y. Not that that's necessarily even his real name, but Denny in Bulgaria. Americans are fixing to accept just as much willingly communism, just like the Slavs, slaves. And, you know, I thought of blacks, too, like South Africa, for example. Aren't they communists, basically? If not outright. He uses a floby. Okay, before I get back to calls, let's cover this, shall we? Excuse me, the people's president, Trump in East Palestine, Ohio. Got a lot of fun attention, right? Yesterday, Wednesday, February 22nd, 2023 AD, I saw a few tweets where Trump came to East Palestine, Ohio. That's where they had the train derailment. And then they set it on fire to avoid it becoming like a shrapnel bomb, these tankers. I think five of the tank, I had a bunch of tankers on this train, and I think five of them had that vinyl chloride stuff. And I had to interrupt, I had to end my call early with Justin in Fullerton, who called and said some things about how he thinks that it may have been a terror attack, meaning like an attack on our own people somehow? By who? I'm not sure. Well, people, there's been like rainbow snow, even up in Canada, there's been like melting snow, and then you see like this rainbow effect from the oily residue in the water and in the clouds and the soil. You've seen like this rainbow oily effect on the surface of the water in the creeks over there in Ohio when you throw a rock or plug a stick down under this creek bed. What a mess. And Justin in Fullerton claimed, I haven't seen it confirmed. Not that I've looked. I don't look very closely, right? I only read CNN, Commie Nonsense Network, and Twitter a little. And a little bit of Telegram, TKR official, but I haven't checked it recently. So he may be talking about it. But he said that they were coughing up blood. You know how people's minds work, too. The suggestion when you Google your condition, you're like, oh, I have this. Your symptoms, you Google your symptoms. And you're like, oh my gosh, I have this. Or, oh my gosh, I feel like my leg's broken. There's like a dent right here when your leg's not broken. I once thought, well, maybe my leg was broken. My friends all, you wouldn't be able to walk. So your mind works you. So your mind is your enemy just as much as the government is your enemy. Or the mainstream media is your enemy. So is your mind, your lying mind. But you do want to be careful with the stuff. Maybe you don't want to necessarily drink tap water. I split my infinitive there. In East Palestine, Ohio, or Flint, Michigan, where the blacks didn't take care of their water supply or pipes or whatever. Or maybe it was the whites who messed them up. Let's watch this clip, clip 11B. There is no clip 11A, so I don't know what's going on. Benny Johnson shared this from Dan Scavino. 2-22-23, that's February 22nd, 2023, Ohio. Minute-long clip of Trump in the little crowd in East Palestine, Ohio. Look at this fun, nice clip. Here it is. There's Trump in his red hat. Look at a cute little kid.
Mr. Trump, what do you make of about Biden not showing up? You showing up before he did.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much.
Hey, Trump, take a picture of my phone.
Nice. Secret Service there. The real I disavow. Hey, John Jr.
My daughter
was
like
that. Oh, yeah.
Mr. Trump, I love you.
Mr. Trump, I love you, baby.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you for your service.
Mr. Trump, are you saying this?
Mr. Trump, oh my God.
Isn't that nice? I think it's nice. Right on. Small town, right? Ohio? Town not brown enough to matter, says Mike Gibson. Yeah, bunch of Republicans. Trump supporters over there. Somebody asked him what his message to Sleepy Joe was, and it was, get over here. I heard on the Jesse Lee Peterson show that he brought them water. Clean water, all kinds of, like, water bottles and some other things. Right on. I heard that he might have gotten a bunch of Big Macs for them. Went to McDonald's. Isn't that nice? Kind of. Maybe. Everyone's so respectful of his personal spaces, Lady Seesaw. Yeah. Joe Biden doesn't care about white people.
People of my stock will become an absolute minority. It's not a bad thing. It's a source of our strength, an unrelenting stream of immigrants coming into our country. We're gonna be majority-minority. That's a source of our strength. Diversity is our strength.
That's Sleepy Joe. He said that one time as vice president. A lot of AU Trump haters or critics or betrayers, or if you feel like he's betrayed you, what do you think about this? I don't care. It's a vaccine salesman. I'm okay with him selling a little bit of vaccine, as long as I don't have to buy it or take it for free. interesting tweet. I have a couple of tweets screenshotted in this folder in reaction to Trump coming. I think Trump's visit to East Palestine, some tweets related to that. Cernovich, Mike Cernovich. He was on the J.C. Lee Peterson show and the Fallen State and men's conference, spoke at a men's conference. He's all, we all know that I want DeSantis and see zero chance for Trump to win a 2024 general election. I'm also a rational man. DeSantis is as well. Ron DeSantis, the Florida governor. Some of these friends and pals are, and fiends are DeSantis supporters. Cringe. Let me get my spittoon. Just kidding. you see these videos like these and wonder how in the world you can win a primary. Just the reality. That's what he says. And there was an interesting reply. So he's like, Trump's going to win the primary, basically. So is DeSantis even going to jump in the race? Who knows? At this point, just a couple of Indians. Not India, not American Indians, India Indians. Well, one of them I think is mixed. Nikki Haley, right? Maybe she's not. Maybe she's full-blown Indian. India Indian. I was laughing the other night. I forgot to mention it yesterday. Evenings ago, I saw that Vivek Ramaswamy guy. I think that's his name. Surprised that I know his name. Who appears on Tucker Carlson a lot. He has a big forehead and big hair. Young guy, whippersnapper guy, CEO, talented, successful. Those immigrants, those India Indians, they come here and make it happen. He's running for president. Is he even old enough? Is he even 35? Maybe he is, apparently. I think you have to be 35 and born here in this country to be the president. Except Ted Cruz was born in Calgary, two quote-unquote American parents. One of them is white. I think his mother. What a mess. So I don't know why I got off. Oh, yeah, because Trump, his only challengers are a couple of foreigners. Nikki Haley, Rhino. But yeah, DeSantis may jump in. Who knows? He probably will. Who knows? I can't predict the future. Well, there's an interesting reply to this man, this Cernovich guy, Mike Cernovich, who's been critical of Trump ever since 2017, really, since he fired that nationalist guy. Who's that nationalist guy? Michael Flynn? General Flynn. One of the Flynns. National Security Advisor. Because Flynn didn't tell Pence something. Oh, dear me, Pence. Like, Pence is so loyal. I don't know how loyal Pence is. I liked him as vice president. And I didn't really mind the thing that he failed to do on January 6th. I didn't really mind it. I couldn't, you know, what do you expect from that guy? You expect him to be all tough? Anyway, here's a reply to Cernovich saying, you know, how is he, you see this crowd, they love him. And he's like a people's person. How is he going to win a primary? How is DeSantis going to win a primary over a man like that? Well, A.J. Delgado, not to be confused with A.J. Gallardo. A.J. Gallardo is a man, or a male, and he's the one who wrote my original The Hake Report theme song, played on Fridays. A.J. Delgado, 13, is a woman, or a female. She's that gal who dated that fat guy, I think, in the Trump campaign and had a baby by him. Talk about immoral, including her and him. The guy who founded Getter or something like that? I'm blanking on his name. Jason or Justin or something like that. She had a baby by him and broke up with him, or he broke up with her or something like that. And then she, I don't know. But her reply is, nah, I count like 25 people in that crowd, that Trump crowd, who showed up to get an autograph picture with a famous politician. Yawn, says this woman. Opening her mouth about politics or tapping her little fingers about politics. I don't know how big her fingers are. Plus, it's a town that's overwhelmingly R Republican. Republican. The fact that that crowd is that small in a very red Ohio town actually bodes badly for Trump. Great for Ron DeSantis in Florida, she says. But a lot of people are interested in this town, so a lot of people on the internet are excited about this. And how big is that town? And how, 25 people, who cares? So I don't know, but it's an interesting comment from a woman, A.J. Delgado. Delgado, doesn't that mean skinny, slim, thin? But anyway. Whatever. Yawn. Who says that? AJ Delgado says that, apparently. Yeah, Jason Miller launched free speech social media platform Getter July 4th, 2021. says, spoiler alert. See, he's not, he's a white man's white man. Not my, he's not my favorite mod for nothing. Meaning he is my favorite mod for a reason. he's been linking Stephen Wiley clips and DeGarmo and Key songs for you guys in the YouTube chat. right on, man. Thank you. What was his name again? Justin Miller. Jason Miller. Jason Miller. Yeah, he's the guy who's kind of fat. Whatever. We'll see how it goes. We'll see how his campaign goes. If it's high energy and real and unique and Trump, then that'll be good. We'll see what happens. She's like, OMG, who even cares? Oh my gosh, who even cares? Whatever, yawn. Yeah, exactly, JKN35. Big Bump says, yeah, Big Bump says this. The population of, this is what crossed my mind too. The population of Palestine, Ohio is only 180, he says. I don't know if that's true or not, but it came from Big Bump, so it's reliable information. Okay, might as well have come from AP, except Big Bump is not far left, enemies of America. 25 people is a lot. Yeah, and probably a lot of them are working or else sick, coughing up blood. They don't want to cough on President Trump. They said the real president. And I disavowed that during the clip, the people over there. But I don't disavow it in the sense that he's like, he has the heart or the spirit or the mind of a president. Whereas this phony guy who's a phony person, Sleepy Joe Biden, the so-called president, he's legitimately the president. We all know that. Up and up, totally most popularly voted ever. 80 million votes. All on the up and up, 100%. But he doesn't have the heart or the soul or the mind or the spirit or the strength of a real president. That's what I mean. Anyway, I have some other corrections to share with you guys. Let me get to, though, first, William in California on the line. How you doing, hey, William?
Man. Hey, what's going on, man?
Hey.
Don't mind me moving around, man. I'm going to take a little drive out to the city and everything. And I see that Mount Baldy. You know about Mount Baldy.
Yeah, I've been there a few times. Yeah, Mount Baldy, California. You drive out to, like, Upland or somewhere.
Yeah, I know where it is.
It's go up?
Like, northwest corner of Ontario and
yeah.
Pomona.
Yeah, yeah. Near Upland on Ontario and all that stuff. Yep.
Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna try
Ontario,
to come down
Ontario, California,
there next,
not Ontario,
I'm gonna try
Canada.
To come down there next month for the Winter National. The races are down there in Pomona.
Okay.
And, yeah, when was the last time you've been to Mount Baldy?
I would say a few to several months ago now, I think. Because right. I was out for 3 months, and I don't think I've been back since. Remember, I was
like
out.
Like Cedar Glen. Like Cedar Glen.
It was probably around my birthday, really.
Yeah. Like Cedar Glen up that way up, and it's really high up in the mountains. It's
yeah.
A lot of snow.
Yep.
But, before I go into what I wanted to talk about, I appreciate Denny's calls. He's always got a great call.
Yeah, I like that man.
Yeah, yeah, and I agree with him. Stay away. Leave that alone.
Yeah, that's your advice in addition
yeah,
with David in Norway?
Yeah.
Interested in a married woman?
I've known a few people from that part of the world, and Denny is absolutely right.
Wow.
There's nothing to play with.
Yeah.
But let's talk about this snake oil that they sell in the blacks up in the bay. I think I'm getting ready to drive over to the city, James, and see what's happening. And they got this little thing about reparations in San Francisco, and it's kind of, if you think about it, it's kind of stupid and everything. They got this thing going, like they're going to get something. And it's like, if you look at how many blacks are actually living in the city of San Francisco compared to the, 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s?
Population's much declined, huh?
Oh, my God, it's under 5%. So who are you going to pay? And you can't pay anybody anything because they weren't slaves.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
I agree with that, man.
So, and Happy Black History Month. I seen that little kid singing on Jesse's show. That was hilarious.
Oh, nice. Which kid singing on
the
Jesse's
little
show?
Bitty guy in church.
Oh.
Wow, wow, wow.
It's so entertaining.
Oh, the Bible Thumper intro. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so they're selling them this snake oil about reparations, and 85% black. What's that about? Probably about under 20,000 blacks in San Francisco. So
nice.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Come on.
Now they're wanting to increase their black population.
You got to divide the payment. Wait a minute. And remember, you got to divide the payment. You know. So yeah, go figure. So you mentioned my hometown where I was born. This morning.
Which one is that?
Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Right on.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think the windmill thing is going to work.
Yeah, that's what I was mentioning in Hake News at the end of hour one, I think it was.
It ain't going to work. The electric grid.
Two.
I don't think that'll work. Not for that part of the country, you know, that's on the Gulf of Mexico.
Yeah, they're doing floating wind turbines,
right.
Or listeners, off the Gulf of Mexico, Galveston, Texas, and Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Yeah, Lake Charles, Galveston, Beaumont, all that. Yeah.
To power millions of homes and create thousands of jobs in the offshore wind industry.
They said that about the Texas situation too, and then they went froze, and then the electric cars didn't work. So
I wonder how many
F-150s.
Do you think it'll kill many birds? Because those wind turbines tend to kill the birds. You find dead birds at the bottom of those.
They say that up, you know. They say that up here in Northern California. We got some windmills over here.
Yeah.
And they don't really generate what you need. You can't really hold a grid.
Okay.
On electric, pure electric power and everything, it could be compromised, and that's pretty much above. You know, people don't think about that.
Wow.
They don't think about that.
Yeah.
You know. It's just kind of crazy because this kid down here in Florida and everything, you know, is this something that the left woke is going to call in and say they don't see that?
Yeah.
All these people killed down there, but this kid, I got sent you the story with the guy's picture and everything. He black.
Oh, yeah, of course. Right. It is.
You see him?
It is a black. Yeah, I've seen him. Oh, I put a couple of screenshots in the transfer folder for the JLP show.
Yeah.
So you could show those. He looks like he has no sense, too. Wild hair sticking up everywhere.
Pretty much.
On purpose. Purposely no sense hair.
Yeah.
He's 19.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He's 19.
Very nice.
I cut him slack. But.
Very nice.
Yeah, he murdered three people.
They heard nothing about that, I guess.
Yeah. Innocent unless proven guilty. But
Look
at this
America.
Guy. He had a long rap sheet, too. They said that he had a long... It looks like he's wearing his hair is shaped kind of like a messed up crown with these pointy things.
Looks like an album cover.
Man.
Looks like a crazy album cover.
He would be a handsome young man had he not done that to his hair.
If he looked like a young man, yeah. You know?
Not good.
You know, he's not African-American. Look at him. He's light-skinned American.
Yeah, he is mixed.
Yeah, okay.
Yep.
Okay.
Not a dark black.
Do you remember them haircuts when you were a kid? You had to get a haircut. You had rules back then.
Yeah.
Terrible. Look at this. Happy black history month. Look at this. Oh, Brittany Griner is pretty pissed off. She only got $160,000.
Oh, that's what she's getting from the WNBA?
Yeah.
But she's a superstar, according to CNN.
Well, the league is a loss. They have no profit.
Right.
And this is every year. So I don't even know.
Is that a fact? They get no profit.
No profit, zero, every year.
Oh, Lord.
So how do you pay your players, you know, more than likely subsidized by the NBA? So, you know, nobody go look at that garbage.
Yeah. Wow. I did not know that about her.
That's what I say. Wow.
We love Brittany Griner here on the Hate Report.
I heard you guys talking about Ali earlier. Earlier this week, it was actually Ernie Terrell that called him out of his name and called him Cassius Clay, and that was like one of the only fighters that Muhammad Ali didn't like.
Oh, okay.
I think he slapped him at the weigh-ins. It's Ernie Terrell. It's Tammy Terrell, the singer with Marvin Gaye. That's her cousin.
Okay.
He called Ali Clay. The same
yeah,
goes,
because we had said
mama,
that it was Joe Frazier.
Your mama named you Clay, I'm going to call you Clay. And,
right.
And Ali didn't like that very much, and he promised himself to stand this man up for several rounds and not knock him out and just punish him.
Hmm.
What an athlete.
Muhammad Ali, better known as Cassius Clay.
Yeah. Terrible father and husband, but what an athlete.
Oh, I didn't know he was a... well, I guess I would... I guess
shoot,
he would
Ali would be with the next woman before he even divorced the last one. That's what you talking about.
Yeah. Trump might have done that, too. We got it.
Absolutely. Yeah, that little town is not that... I don't want to let you go. I'm going to take me a drive to the city. That city is where Trump was. I don't think that is too many people there at all.
You know what? I have a correction from Big Bump that it's not a population. Palestine, Ohio is 180, but East Palestine, Ohio is 4,761. So it's still quite small.
Yeah. Yep. You got districts.
But 180, it's a big difference.
You got districts in some major cities that have more people than that. Districts, not cities. Districts.
Oh, yeah, right.
And so that's not that big.
Yep.
Not that big.
And plus, they're white, so they're working. And
well,
Trump visited on a Wednesday.
Ohio's red.
Yep.
Ohio's red, and he's probably going to overwhelmingly win that state.
Yeah.
You know? We got a family got jumped on and beat up in a sideshow, got caught in the middle of a sideshow out there in Sacramento.
Oh, hadn't heard about that.
Woke left didn't see that either.
Terrible, man.
Well, it'd be over with. It'd be over with. They pretty much know that nothing's going to come out of what they're doing the last 2 years. And they know they're not getting reelected. And I think that they're just basically tearing everything up on the way out the door.
Awful, man. I appreciate it, William. It's good to hear from you, man.
All right. You too, man. Have a good day.
You too. Take care.
All right.
Bye. So some corrections, guys. I am a little slow. I have known this for some time. Big Bump sent me this screenshot of that album Funkdafied by that lady, Da Bump. Somebody was like, we want to know Denny from Bulgaria's opinion on Da Bump's pregnancy. Da Bump, that 48-year-old rapper who maybe a lesbian. I don't know. Because she said that she's, quote-unquote, married to this woman, Jessica, with an E, no I, and Jessica. Judy, some hyphenated last name. And she's pregnant. How do you be pregnant by her? You're not. But Funkdafied, it's not Funkified. It's Funkdafied. And I falsely accused CNN of misspelling it Funkified, but no, that was Hake. It's just my reading comprehension or my attention. Big Bump sent me this screenshot of this album or single cover, whatever, from Da Brat's 1994 smash hit, Funkdafied. I don't know if I recommend that song, but I don't know if you listen to my recommendations after hearing Hake music, which is not fake music. But I didn't catch that on CNN, which is very fake news. Did not spell it wrong. They spelled it Funkdafied too. They said they wrote the Funkdafied rapper. I'm like, oh yeah, that helps. That helps clarify who she is. I'm like, who's Da Brat? But Hassan knew who she was. And Big Bump knew who she was. 1994 smash hit Funkdafied. And she did a song with Missy Elliott, but it was forgettable, according to Hassan. And he's a reliable source, I think. And I just didn't read it carefully. I'm like, oh, the Funkified one? So anyway, Hake is very fake news. And Palestine, once again, Palestine. There is, I guess, a Palestine, Ohio, he says, Big Bump says. That's 180 population, 180 people. But it's over 4,000 in East Palestine, Ohio. 4761 East Palestine, Ohio. Nice. Shout out to the rappers. By the way, Stephen Wiley, I'm going to play another Stephen Wiley at the end of the show, not now. Stephen Wiley's intro rap and heroes track that I played yesterday, I guess, at the beginning of the show. Somebody in the chat said, 80s rappers could only rap one syllable at a time. Nice. Pretty funny. I thought that was worth sharing. Guys, it's time for a break for Hake. And it's time for you to listen to Christian music. Let's listen to DeGarmo and Key. I used to sing this song to myself all the time. I'm Accepted. Enjoy from 1989, The Pledge album. And you can cover your ears, press mute, or grin and bear it, you musical Philistines. And I'll be right back for hour two. Hang tight. Here it is. So good. Accepted. I'm accepted by the one who matters most. I'd sing this song to myself in high school. 1989. Such a nice message. I'm accepted. I'm accepted. This is why I don't go to church anymore. I'm accepted by the one who matters most. level water is flat, says Flat Sabbath. You are accepted. Somebody did a mute emoji. Nice. More solo work by DeGarmo and Key. Yeah, they're good guitarists, right? Oh, Lord, slay me now, Hake, says Steve C. Smash hit. Oh, no, that's a reference to Da Brat. No, nothing of her songs. Such a smash hit, I never heard of her until whatever. Anyway, I was kidding around with that. Jalopy says, you keep telling people to leave the cities. Don't think he's referring to me, because I don't tell people to leave the cities. But some people do. Get out of the cities if you can, says Red Scout. Please don't play any black lesbian music on the Hake Report. You are accepted, yes. Made you feel nice emotionally, but didn't increase your confidence, actually. Right? Just gave you a feeling. Typical music, the language of Satan, right? Super chat from Evil is Real. Eat the rainbow snow, chat. Evil Israel has some vindictiveness for his fellow chatters. What a mess. Terrible. Do not eat the rainbow snow. It's just like, don't eat the yellow snow. Don't eat the rainbow snow either. The rainbow snow from that floated all the way from those dark clouds of vinyl chloride smoke or whatever else was in the poisonous toxic train derailment chemical spill burn off from the feds or whoever burned it. I don't know who burned it. That floated all the way up to Canada. How far is it from East Palestine, Ohio to Ottawa? What was it? I forget where it was. Somewhere in Canada. I'm a loser, says somebody. If you think you're a loser, just remember, and you fail at everything you do, just remember there's a savior. Nice. Well, thank you, guys. I didn't realize Creed was the peak of that genre. It's not Creed, man. DeGarmo and Key, way better than Creed. No, I don't know. I can't speak on Creed. I'd never really listened to them much. That guy's a pastor's kid. Isn't he a pastor's kid? Creed reminds me of Lifehouse a little bit. Lifehouse. I like that one song from Lifehouse, right? Anyway, let me get to Art in Ohio, who's on the line. I may have to disavow some of his statements here coming up right here. Art in Ohio, thanks for calling and holding. How you doing, man?
Omar, how you doing?
Doing fine, thank you.
First things first. I want to. This ain't something that I didn't know about Trump, but I want to thank him from Ohio or whatnot. You know, for going to Palestine, Ohio. That ain't nothing that I wouldn't expect him to do. That's the type of fella he is or whatnot.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Sleepy Creepy Joe is I already expect what he did out of him. You know what I mean? He got some vested interest over there in Ukraine. So, of course, he ain't going to be for America or whatnot. That's where he's money laundering at. Allegedly, you know what I mean, money laundering American tax dollars in Ukraine or whatnot. So yeah, I would expect that he would go tend to Ukraine or whatnot. But I want to tell Donald Trump, thank you so much for, you know, doing that. You know, Ohio, we don't need that. We gonna stand with Palestine, Ohio. We're going to take care of our own business in Ohio. So we don't need nothing from Donald Trump or, you know what I mean, the rest of America, whatnot. Ohio's a strong strong state, and we can stand by ourselves and whatnot, and that's what we're going to do. We don't need no dirt balls coming around here, no busters, no fake love. We don't need you to come over here and try to nuke our towns or nuke Ohio with no chemical warfare and then come back and pat us on the back and tell us everything's going to be all right when you knew what you was doing from the start. So no, you Palestine, Ohio, you doing Joe Biden and all them other pop Buttigieg, whatever the other dude, Pete, what's the other dude's name who's supposed to been went down there too?
The black EPA administrator or Pete Buttigieg?
No, I don't know if it's Pete Buttigieg. It's another white dude that they've been showing on the news that he's supposed to be over the over all that, or either the transit stuff or whatnot. Long story short, we don't need none of them them busters around in this area or whatnot. You keep yourself where y'all's at. Y'all stay where y'all at. We don't need your help. We don't need the fake love. And you can take that from Artie Art, Ohio, because that's the bottom line, because Artie Art said so, and you better believe it. And second thing is, have you been hearing about all these young people that's been passing out and dying of cardiac arrest or whatnot lately?
I have seen, I've seen instances after instances of young people collapsing and different people collapsing on camera and on the fields and on basketball courts and I think and other stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I have heard, I have seen a lot of people's antennas are up about that. So I don't know if it's happening more or if people are just noticing it more because they're looking out for that type of thing. You know what I mean?
Well,
some people say everybody, that it is happening more.
Yeah, definitely. It definitely is. But I just want to let y'all, you and everybody else know, Ohio, we're going to get to the bottom of what's going on or whatnot. We ain't sweeping nothing under the rug. Everybody else might be scared to talk about it. Everybody else might not want to say nothing about it, but we're going to get to the bottom line of what's going on with that. So you ain't got to even worry about that. It's only a matter of time. We're going to figure out what's going on right as we speak. We're going to figure out what's going on. But I would speculate that, I would speculate that I would think that most of that stuff is coming from that, that liquid juice they were shooting up at people, when this shutdown stuff was going on. But I also went to think it was high or far fetched.
You're out in the wind, because we're getting a lot of noise sometimes from you here and there.
Okay, yeah, I am. Sorry about that.
Okay,
I'm gonna try to get on here and get off. But I wouldn't speculate that most of that is probably coming from that fentanyl stuff that they've been letting come across the border, neither.
Oh, you're talking about what's the fentanyl causing?
Well, I went all that cardiac arrest stuff. I went down if it's coming from that fentanyl stuff.
It may be. I don't know about athletes taking fentanyl. Man, there's too much noise right now from your phone, Art. But I appreciate your call, man. Good to hear from you.
Take care. Go ahead. I catch up with you later.
Sounds good. Adios, man.
All right, buddy.
All right.
Yep.
Bye. What a mess. Super chat from Evil Is Real. Another super chat. Evil Is Real. Supporting hate today. And whatnot. Based speech from our true representative, says Evil Is Real. And I think that that's completely sincere and not sarcastic at all. Thank you, Evil Is Real. Appreciate that, man. Stats are up. Could be drugs, but vax most likely. Which I, of course, disavow, but that's what Dennis 2020 says. Over there on rumble.com. Hake was suspended on YouTube a week or so ago. And so there are people watching Hake on Rumble, as well as Odyssey. Shout out to the Odyssey crew. Anybody over there on Facebook? I did see some people liking it on Facebook. Indeed. Nice. Let me get to this story here about this. Well, it's not a story. It's a tweet. Interesting tweet that I thought I would see if you guys wanted to react about it. Great, gross topic, not a great topic. Bryson Gray's tweet. Watch how you react to this. Defensive? Gleeful? Puffing up over bad info? I don't know if the info is bad or not. I don't know how good of a, how reliable of a source Bryson Gray is. Is he better than Big Bump? I just called Big Bump as reliable as AP or more. But more honorable towards America. More a friend of America, that's for sure. CCG Bryson. Real Bryson Gray. He's been on the J.C. Lee Peterson show, I believe, right? Hasn't he? This rapper guy, MAGA-type rapper guy. And he quote tweeted this, this one tweet from one guy named Emilio2763 on Twitter. February 21st, a couple of days ago. And it was a tweet of your typical black ladies, and I may be using the term loosely, but mildly attractive black gals, females, fighting in like a restaurant. I call it a restaurant, a fast food joint. I don't know if it's fast food joint, but one of them is throwing chairs. They're just inter-black violence, which is more frequent than inter-white violence. Even though 80% of white on white crime is white on white, something like that, Earl from Michigan said. But anyway, it's way out of control in the black community. But only a tiny percentage, one point something percent, commit violent crime, according to one of my callers. I almost said one of my favorite or least favorite. I wasn't sure what I was going to say. And this Emilio guy says, there's something so similar about all these videos, meaning fight videos, big old mob fights, royal rumbles, but not so royal. Are they Kangs and Quains? If black men are Kangs, or were Kangs, are the black women Quains? I just thought of that. It's not that funny. So he's pretending like he can't quite figure out what's so similar about all these videos, but what he's implying, Emilio, I presume it's a he, is that it's blacks fighting. Blacks always fighting in these videos. And so real Bryson Gray, and this is an unpleasant topic, but I'll try to keep it clean for you guys and gals. You know, Hake. We keep it PG at worst, sometimes R. I agree, says Bryson. Yeah, it's always the blacks fighting in these videos. So commonly, anyway. There's sometimes you find others. Some of those Asians getting a little out of control. Sometimes those Hispanics and whites, even. I agree, but I can do this with pedophile catcher videos, says real Bryson Gray. And the race would be different. Implying who? Implying the whites. They say, oh, whites are pedophiles. And I think that that's an unfair, untrue stereotype. You know, the stereotype is that whites are disproportionately the pedophiles. I don't think that that's true. I don't think that they're... I think that the blacks even are disproportionate compared to whites. But I think his information differs. And it's such a gross topic. I don't know. So I saw one of the replies said 1% of both populations, 1% of blacks and 1% of whites. Whoa, 1 in every 100 people are pedophiles? Anyway, let's not talk about that topic. Let's not say that word. But yeah, I don't think it's 1% of any population, but I could be wrong. And you know, I haven't read entirely Ann Coulter's book, but in Ann Coulter's book, there's like horrific crimes committed by the illegals or foreigners from south of the border. So there's some shenanigans. And you think of the different cultures of blacks and Hispanics, they're very sexual. And whites are a little bit less sexual, and Asians don't present themselves as very sexual. Yeah, they do, but they don't, not as much. So, and you know, the black rape statistics is much higher. But I don't know. I don't know. But isn't that interesting? And it, like, when I read that tweet, it pulled on me to, like, puff up. One, because I had looked into the violent crime and the so-called sex crimes and stuff like that. And two, I don't know, I don't think of myself as identifying with the white thing. Even though I am white, I do appreciate the rebel flag. But I don't know if I really identify with that stuff that much. Maybe I identify with it a little bit, right? Bryson tweeted in response is a follow-up tweet in his thread, a little thread, two-tweet thread. Now watch the same people that love talking about black people get sensitive about their race in the comment section. I talk crap about the black community every day. Sorry, kids. So you can't call me pro-black either, except that you're just as sensitive as BLM. LOL. And so that's him, but I don't know if that's true. Is it true? I believe that probably in the To Catch a Predator videos, it is roughly majority, or vast majority white. not even white Hispanic. And I've heard that, you know, in Iraq, and, well, not necessarily Iraq, but the Middle East, different places, they have their bachi something, which is a vulgar thing. I don't know. So I was looking at the replies. The replies were interesting, of course. Mr. Reagan, who's been on the Fallen State with Jesse Lee, said, I feel like pedophilia is severely condemned by white culture, though. I don't think violence is condemned strongly enough by black culture. Bryson says, neither of these are true. Bryson Gray. Black people call out black-on-black crime all the time. A lot of us actually use the phrase black-on-black crime. I think both of those are true, Bryson. The whites tell on each other. And the whites kind of celebrate when, which I don't agree with this, celebrate when some guy who's convicted of some type of wrong crime, against, especially against a kid, gets killed in jail. You know, that street justice stuff? Because I feel like it's a false self-righteousness. Oh, let's let all these other criminals be all righteous, self-righteous against the, and these non-criminals, alleged non-criminals, people who are not in jail, be all self-righteous against the child sex stuff, right? Oops, sorry. I shouldn't have said it like that. That didn't help. That's not any cleaner. Another person says, stats show you're wrong. 52% of all violent crime is the same group of men. Nope, stats say I'm right. 81%, says Bryson, of people convicted of CP. I won't tell you what CP is, but CP. Okay, maybe I'll say it once, maybe. Are white, he says. And I think he means non-Hispanic white, but I'm not sure. Whereas he says 69% are white. I think it's 63. White non-Hispanics. Black people responsible for robberies and homicides, not all crime, he says. Blah, blah, blah. One guy says, only because no one reports PDF files in the hood. And Bryson says, this is the dumbest argument I've ever seen. But I think that there's a lot of truth to that, honestly. Because, you know, they don't report that. Well, you know, it's an unspoken thing. Happens a lot. Sexual abuse is rampant in black communities. You think pimps only take girls over 18? I said something specific. Let's talk about CP conviction rates. Look it up, says Bryson. Actually, blacks are represented to the same proportion whites are in this category and overrepresented in sex crimes in general. It's not just as noticeable as the glaring overrepresentation blacks have in violent crimes. Nope, says. He's actually statistically correct. And this person says 1% of each population are convicted. I don't think are convicted PDFs. PDFs is what I'm saying instead of the other word. 1%? 1%, man, where did you get that? People on Twitter, not necessarily reliable sources after all. DOJ does state blacks are overrepresented on the sex offender registry. I don't know, man. And then they're going to sex offenders, which is a little bit of a different thing, you know. Sorry, kids. I don't even like saying that word. What a mess. Such an unpleasant, gross topic. But it's sort of interesting, though, because I don't know what the truth is. Nor do I really care. I'm not doing that stuff. So why am I, like, getting defensive about the other whites who may be doing that stuff? Not normal whites, typically, right? Oh, yeah, and people... Like, who's that one guy who supported Black Lives Matter? He's Jewish. He's atheist. He ran for president. He's an independent. He's socialist, Democrat socialist. Bernie Sanders. He said years ago, I saw it on a Owen Benjamin clip, that Jews are, the stereotype of Jews is that they're immoral, perverted in that sex way, right? And you look at what they support, many of them support, yeah. They don't seem to be Christian in their values in that way, many of them. So I don't know. And this woman, Jess, says, yep, sort of like rape would be mostly male perpetrators versus females. I think that women are underrepresented compared to their actual statistics on that, because men don't report it, and then women... Males are usually lose their virginity to older females. Did you know that? Did you know that? Just FYI. Doesn't mean that they're women are rapists or young or older girls are rapists, but I'm just saying. Another guy says, probably still happens just as much. I think that was due to computer literacy and access. You know how whites and Asians know their computers better. So Bryson, I found stats that Bryson tweeted in reply to somebody. Here's what where he got his stats, sort of, maybe. No, he did. 81% of people caught with child CP, sorry, kids, adults, ladies, gentlemen, are white. He says 81% of people caught with that. And I'm like, who's investigating this stuff? The FBI, the anti-white FBI liberals? They're not investigating the blacks, are they? Oh, I don't know. Those forums, though, I don't know. Also, they're more likely to victimize children, which I don't know where he got that. He may be right, but I don't think he's right. But he may be right, but I don't think so. But he may be. Again, and he says, I don't care about these statistics. I only bring them up to prove hypocrisy. And it is interesting, like something in me like puffs up. I don't know if it's over knowledge or over the white thing or both. You know how the blacks always use this. Oh, we may be violent, but you guys are pedophiles. Sorry, kids. I don't like that word. So the quick facts, 99.7% of offenders were male, 81.3% were white. This is according to some lawyer's blog post from 2020 stats. 81.3% were white, 12.2% were Hispanic, 4% were black, 2.5% other races. Average age of the CP offender was 42, according to this stats screenshot that he shared from wendellodom.com, a lawyer firm blog. And I don't get how they get the breakdown on whites. He says that 69% of the country is white people. I don't think that's true. It's 63% at most. But maybe he's talking about adults or something. Somebody said 75.8% are white. Maybe that's if you count the Hispanics. I don't get it. I don't get the breakdown. White Hispanics, you know, there's most Hispanics are considered white by the feds. So I don't know. Somebody said 75%, but they look at the PDF files and child assault, and I'm leaving out a word, the S word. Assault is different from CP, unless you're the one making the CP. I don't know. What a mess. Gross. Terrible topic. I'm going to move on shortly here. You only have to cover your ears for one more minute. They said nearly half of the registered... Oh, okay, so they're talking about so-called sex offender, registered sex offenders, which is a different topic. It's not specifically the child thing. 20% black, 20% Hispanic, and less than half Caucasian. Whatever, I don't know. Gross, huh? I only really brought it up because it caught my attention and because I've looked into it and found different stats from what he found, but I wasn't looking into that specific topic. But the feds are the ones who've chased that stuff. Trump was going after them a lot, I heard. At least the trafficking, the sex trafficking stuff. But I was mainly interested in it because of the... got a rise out of me to be like, what's going on here? Read all the comments and stuff. Anyway. Real Bryson Gray. Nice guy, though. Good guy. If any guy is good. Let's see here. You know, I covered yesterday that nutty jury four... I feel so ridiculous calling her a four-person female foreman. jury foreman grand jury for the Trump investigation. I'm laughing because that guy who called my show from Phoenix, Joe from Sleepy Joe from Phoenix, thinks, oh, it's not politically motivated. It's not out of Trump hate at all. It's totally on the up and up. Yeah, right. This lady with the weird faces. Shall I show it one more time? Can you find the clips from yesterday? Yesterday's clips. I think it's 11A and 11B, probably. Commie Nonsense Network, CNN, and MSLSD interviewed this gal named Emily Kors. And she's all into these different Wiccan stuff, like female witch religion stuff. Nutty lady. Young lady. Mildly attractive. Mildly horrific. She's mixed. A mixture of attractive and horrific. Here's some clips of her, a couple of clips of her. Let's, just a refresher on yesterday's mildly attractive young lady. Here she is.
There are indictments recommended, of course. Is it yes. more than 12 people? Is it more than 20 people?
I think if you look at the page numbers of the report, there's about 6 pages in the middle that got cut out. Allow for spacing. It's not a short list.
Not a short list. More, I mean, when it comes to 75 witnesses, like, I assume, of course, it's right. not 75 people. Would you characterize it as 20-ish people?
I can't say I counted.
She makes these funny
more
faces.
More than a dozen, though, I think I heard you say in another interview.
Acting like she's cute.
I believe so.
She is.
That's probably a good assumption.
The name that everyone wants to know about is former President Trump.
Of course.
Our
Did
greatest.
You recommend charges against Donald Trump?
I really don't want to share something that the judge made a conscious decision not to share. I will tell you that it was a process where we heard his name a lot. We definitely heard a lot about former President Trump, and we definitely discussed him a lot in the room. And I will say that when this list comes out, there are no major plot twists waiting for you.
Personally, want to hear from the former president.
I wanted to hear from the former president, but honestly, I kind of wanted to subpoena the former president because I got to swear everybody in. And so I thought it'd be really cool to get 60 seconds with President Trump of me looking at him and being like, do you solemnly swear? And me getting to swear him in. I kind of thought that would be an awesome moment.
Somebody pointed out yesterday how she's like looking down. I think because she's so like nervous and funny and trying to be cute. Is she funny? Somebody said her teeth look like butter. I don't know. Yellow teeth. Nothing wrong with the little yellow teeth. I got yellow teeth. It's not the whitest anyway. Maybe they're getting better. I'm going to the dentist. I've been going to the dentist. She got this hook nose, looks like a witch, the Wicked Witch of one of the West or something. Slam Free Poetry speculates she may not be a normal white, right? Maybe one of the Bernie Sanders types. Is Bernie Sanders? Yeah, Bernie Sanders. May not be a Christian. Can you be a Christian and be a Trump hater? She will be a host on CNN or NBC soon. I don't know. I think that everybody saw kind of through her as she is a real-life cartoon character. Somebody said that she's like acting like an anime. And according to Nick, who jumped in here on the board operation for Hassan just a moment ago, said that we saw Jack Posobiec, based Jack Posobiec, tweeted out about her. Somebody found her purported Emily Kors, is K-O-H-R-S. Pinterest. Yeah, of course. A young lady, liberal young lady, Trump hater maybe, has a Pinterest. And it's a bunch of, like, he called them anime symbols. But they look like ancient druid or awesome, like, German or something. Ancient stuff type symbols. Not necessarily Christian, though. Anyway. Yeah, that nose was casting a shadow down on her. Because she was holding her goblin beak nose. she was holding her head down so, like, the the lighting on her face was casting a shadow down on her teeth. What a mess. But anyway, I find her mildly attractive, kind of cute, but she was trying to play cute, which was not cute. And then also, her facial expressions, and like people were saying she's possessed. Big Bump says she's definitely possessed. Nick says some of those symbols were historical. Some were directly from an anime, which were heavily influenced by that German symbol stuff. Oh, okay. So, wow. So they came up with their own stuff based on that. Inspired by. Wow. Pretty convincing items. So, anyway. CNN's reaction to the four-person, they're calling him four-person. How did she become the foreman? I've been on a jury before. Actually, I think I was an alternate for a jury. And they selected this white man as the jury foreman. And it just made so much sense. He was just like its natural leader. So is that the best they came up with down in Georgia? Where in Georgia is... Hake finds everything mildly attractive. Whatever. Doesn't seem like a natural leader to me, but maybe she has some leadership qualities. CNN's reaction to the four-person... I hate that word. I'm using air quotes hard. Is Jeanette Korzenko still watch Hake's show? She used to not like that. Angel Witch. this is an anti-Semitic meme here. I disavow it. No, I'm just kidding. No, he took it away. Nick showed a profile outline drawing of, like this, your typical old Disney princess, angel profile, with the nose slightly turned up, all cute. Angel skull versus witch skull, he says. Profile. It's not a skull, but anyway. And then a witch has, like, and the angel has more of a defined chin, whereas a witch has less of a defined chin, where it kind of falls into the neck. And, like, the nose kind of hooks down and is more hooked. More, not hooked, kind of a beak nose. Interesting. Terrible. Like an older lady-looking thing. But a lot of people note that Jewish noses are more hooked. And, white noses are more... I don't know, mine is more, like, Roman, I guess. Anyway, whatever. I'm not an angel or a witch. The Chad meme, that's Hake. That's Nix. That's a Nix. That's kind. The CNN's reaction after the four-person of the grand jury went on their own network. Four-person of the grand jury that investigated our greatest president, Donald J. Trump, in Georgia, making her rounds on cable news. Why is this person talking on TV? I do not understand. I guarantee you, prosecutors are wincing. It's a prosecutor's nightmare. And somebody else on Twitter also said that the defense was licking their lips, and the Trump supporters licking their lips. Hake with the echoes around Hake. Yeah, what a mess. It's getting hot in here. But it's stuffy, but we can't open the door because I think there's people having meetings out there, whatever. Turn on the AC and open the vent. I don't know if you're allowed to turn on the AC. It's middle of it's the dead of winter. So that's the... CNN is cringing that they... Whose idea was it to have that gal on there? Sort of a typical physiognomy, whatever. Check. Sort of a typical Trump hater. What you would expect, I guess. It's okay now to have the door open? Okay, cool. Nice. Speaking of commie nonsense, based Don Lemon. Oh, right on. Smart. Smart man. Based Don Lemon. This is from February 22nd. Don Lemon on Twitter tweeted yesterday. I may have the screenshot. I may not. I forget. I appreciate the opportunity to be back on CNN this morning, today, meaning yesterday, to my network, my colleagues, and our incredible audience, which is Hake. Thank you, Don Lemon. No, I don't watch CNN. I only read their morning news. I'm sorry. Don't apologize to me, Don Lemon. You had nothing to apologize for except for calling Trump racist and being dumb and gay, being all outwardly thinking that that's cool. It's not cool. Anyway, I've heard you. I'm learning from you, and I'm committed to doing better. See you soon. That's what he tweeted, his apology. And so here are the headlines. We just showed the headlines from when I searched Don Lemon on Google, which is evil. Don Lemon offers a generic apology for his Nikki Haley comments. That's what the Washington Compost says. CNN this morning ratings rose 5% during Lemon's absence. Well, I could believe that because Lemon doesn't seem to have, he's turned sour, if I can use that pun. I'm white. I don't know, whatever. Don Lemon to return to CNN, undergo formal training, according to AP. Ridiculous. Ridiculous. And so I looked it up on Wikipedia to get the real news. Hey, using Wikipedia, at least I'm protecting my channel, right? Spoiler alert posted to Don Lemon's tweet. Thank you, man. Over on the YouTube chat. In 2023, after Nikki Haley's presidential campaign announcement, Don Lemon said Haley isn't in her prime. And I'll read the context for you later. And that a woman is considered to be in her prime in her 20s and 30s and maybe 40s, said Don Lemon, according to Google. The comments went viral and received widespread negative reactions. My reactions were not negative. It was funny and cute and whatever. With many labeling his comments sexist. Reality in Google and Mother Nature and Nature's God is sexist. Commie Nonsense Network CNN CEO Chris Licht, L-I-C-H-T, perhaps not a Christian, condemned the statements. Lemon apologized for the statements and did not appear on CNN this morning on February 20th. Lemon was set to return to CNN this morning, February 22nd, following formal training. So I showed you some of the dumb headlines over Don Lemon. Washington Compost had this one. It was they did a whole op-ed, or this gal, Monica Hesse, did this whole op-ed. Don Lemon returned with an apology in a can. And let me read that subtitle there. How much listening and learning must this man do to realize sexism is bad? So wrote the perspective. So wrote Monica Hesse, H-E-S-S-E. Hess? Hesse? Hess. Whatever. And Don Lemon is pictured CNN heroes with alongside a couple of, I guess those are ladies? Caitlin Collins and Poppy Harlow. One of them looks, the transgenders have poisoned my mind now. I can't even tell. You see the one on the left? Looks like it might be a dude. Can't tell, man. Anyway. Formal training, whatever. Oh, here's a cringy one from Fox News. Faux News. The View ignores CNN host Don Lemon's attack on Nikki Haley despite sexism and ageism themes at play. So says Fox News. Faux News, the ABC News, ABC, The View. ABC is the outlet, right? The View hosts criticized Nikki Haley but ignored Don Lemon calling women over 50 past their prime. And that's an article by Joseph A. Wolfson, a purported male kissing up to women. Oh, here's a nice, by the way, Don Lemon. This is from Daily Beast. Don Lemon draws the ire of female co-hosts by crapping. Sorry, kids. I don't like that word. On women's soccer. Guys, am I wrong? The former primetime anchor tangled with his new morning co-hosts, females. The dumb females were dumb, not him. Sorry, children, don't call people dumb too much. What did he say? This is an article by Justin Barragona. Simp. Weak. Don't call people simps too much, kids. when he declared that men's sports are more interesting to watch than women's, and that's a fact. That's why men get the men's sports make more money. As that man who called from whatever you call it, California, William said, WNBA operates at a loss, according to him. I don't know if that's true or not, but clearly, like, men are better athletes. So that's dumb. Silly. That was from December. I played that, I think, last year. Oh, listen to this one. This is from Slate, which you can't tell, but it says, Don Lemon is so confused about a woman's prime. Let me help you out, Don, says Heather Schwedel. Listen to all these people with no sense of humor. Not that Don Lemon maybe meant to be funny. I think he was just being sort of not even purposely being silly. I'm not even sure what he meant. To me, it was funny, though. But these people are sensitive. Makes you think that there may be some truth to it, that they're women don't belong there. February 16th, this woman writes, Heather Schwedel at Slate, far left, enemies of America outlet. This afternoon, a CNN anchor, on CNN anchor Don Lemon's orders, I found myself Googling when it was a woman in her prime. I didn't find myself Googling it. I didn't even find myself Googling real Bryson Gray's tweet about catch a predator stuff. Not interested. Lemon accidentally created our, I don't know what he said. I don't know that word. When he issued said instruction on Thursday on CNN this morning, because Google's top results are now littered with news stories. Oh, yeah. It all started during here's the context. This is why I wanted to read this. It all started during a discussion of Nikki Haley's announcement of her presidential run. She doesn't belong. In her speech, the former governor of South Carolina, disgraceful. Shame on you, South Carolina, voting for her. I don't know what your choices were. Called for mandatory mental competency tests for politicians older than 75. I say you need competency tests maybe for all of them. But that's like beyond, you need spiritual competency. Don Lemon responded and made him uncomfortable. He said Haley, who is 51, should stay away from criticizing politicians being past their prime because she's already past hers. A woman's prime includes 20s, 30s, 40s, maybe 50s. He apologized for calling it inartful and irrelevant. I thought it was artful. I thought it was funny. It may have been kind of irrelevant, not totally irrelevant, which is not the same as wrong, but the moment was so bizarre that it's worth lingering on. Oh, and by the way, Nikki Haley. Nikki Haley tweeted out that she's giving out, well, there's a whole headline from The Hill. Nikki Haley is selling merch based off of Don Lemon's age comments. For all you who took issue with the haters saying that we are past our prime, this one's for you. We've got this. Order yours today. Past my prime? Hold my beer. And that's a beer holder. I disavow beer. Claim your koozie so you can order yours from winred.com from Nikki Haley. A cringy rhino liberal. Psh, whatever. So anyway, that's enough of that. Dumb story. But yeah, Mike Cernovich, who's been on the JLP show, I mentioned him earlier, last hour. He said that we live in a gynocracy or something like that, meaning the women rule. Yeah, and got Don Lemon groveling, apologizing, and no man would, if like he had mocked men or something like that, he wouldn't be apologizing, or maybe he would, but he wouldn't be suspended or whatever. Groveling. Men don't take that stuff that personally. Women do, for some odd reason, makes you think that they don't really belong where they think they belong. But I disavow that for the sake of my channel, maybe. I don't know. Has Hake ever gotten a strike? Anyway, for sexism? No such thing. Let's move on. Let me get to a caller here, guys. Kentucky John from Kentucky on the line. How you doing, John?
I'm doing excellent, man. But why are you such a hypocrite, Hake? why are you such a hypocrite, dude?
You're asking me why I'm such a hypocrite?
Yes.
Okay. I think it's human nature. I think it's human nature. We all are hypocrites, maybe.
So you admit it? Okay, well.
But what makes me a hypocrite?
Because you were complaining about people celebrating the death of pedophiles, knowing how evil those people can be. Yet you celebrate the death of every black person that's in the news dying from the hands of a cop or any of those situations where it's a racial issue. You always take the side of the white person, and you mock their name. You laugh at their moms for crying at press conferences. You're just a hypocrite.
But
and that's pretty evil. That's pretty evil of you.
But, man, I'm not celebrating their death. That's not fair. That's not a fair characterization of what I do. Some of what you're saying is true, is accurate. Like, I do mock their names, but I mock their names not to mock them, but to mock the people who are like, say their names, because those people don't care about them. So that's why I do that. But I get, but you're right. I sometimes do take sides. I do fall into taking sides. I have fallen into taking sides of like the cops or the white. But I'm also kind of like, I want to not take sides. And a lot of times, I'm also like, I go against the trends a lot. It's kind of like a natural thing of me. Not a good thing, necessarily. But the trend is to take the side of the poor victim, George Floyd, for example.
And
I had a little bit of sympathy for him at the very beginning. I'm like, oh, yeah, get off his neck. That doesn't look right, man. But
it wasn't right.
But I don't know if it was right or wrong now.
No, it was definitely wrong.
But
it was definitely wrong.
But, you know, pedophiles are evil, but so are the people who are like, judging the pedophiles also evil.
Why don't you mock them then instead of taking up for them all the time?
Because there's nobody falling all over themselves sympathizing with the with the PDF files. I'm going to call them PDF files.
Well, you call out the people who are saying, good for you. You should have died. You shouldn't have touched those kids.
Well,
you call them out.
Right. I call them out because they're living. I bet you I have more of an audience of the people that cheer the death than an audience of PDF files, is my guess. I would hope. I don't know.
My guess is a lot of your viewers are probably pedophiles.
No, man. Don't say that. That's wrong. You're speculating. That's not honesty. You're honestly misguided and a snake.
I'm being honest, man.
But you're not being accurate. Now,
most of my callers
and people, they may be crazy, but they're very much against the deep state, Jeffrey Epstein, and all these guys who are doing stuff to kids.
That was Trump's friend too, you know. Close friend. Business associate.
You're changing the subject. I'm talking about my audience.
I know. Go ahead, man. I'm messing with you.
Yeah, yeah. So, like, those people are the who I speak. I like to speak to my audience, and I like to speak to myself too. And I like you too are in my audience, right? A number of
Israelites. Yeah, but I'm nowhere close to the way of your supporters.
Okay.
Though.
Like, yeah, I understand. You don't like. I don't know if anything that I say that's true that's ever sinks into you, but some of it may sink into my audience, and I try to appeal to my audience to be better, and me too. Well, I like to call us to be better. Hake, not to overreact to Bryson Gray's tweet and stuff like that.
Well, I'll tell you what, I do agree with you.
A lot of my listeners are harsh Jew critics, or. You know, some of them may be overly fed up with the blacks, and I'm like, oh, we love black people, and we love the Jews.
All right. You love them all right.
And we love the Jews.
You played a clip.
Yeah.
You played a clip about Trump the other day. I agree with 90% of what he said, man.
What did he say?
About the United States being just a perverted place and, you know, pushing that stuff on the kids, and
yeah.
He was against it.
Right.
I was on board with all of that.
Right.
Like, I'm on board with all of that.
Yeah, see, but that's what I was trying to tell you.
It's the racial stuff. It's the racial stuff that gets me. Because
okay.
Y'all are blinded by y'all's hatred, and y'all put us all under this umbrella that I can't stand.
What umbrella am I putting you under?
Not all, but most, which is a lie. If y'all wouldn't say that, man, y'all probably get more supporters like me. But y'all have to keep that up because y'all supporters love to hear y'all say that stuff and love to hear y'all down us.
Now, you're talking, it sounds like you're talking about JLP and Hake, because that's the JLP line. Because I don't say not all, but most. I don't say not all, but most. I don't generally say that. But anyway, that's kind of beside the point. But a lot, like, you identify with the black thing. Like, watch what goes on inside of you that is overreacting to that.
No, I don't get into y'all's philosophy, because I know that's all it is philosophy.
Philosophy is love of philosophy is love of wisdom. You better be loving wisdom. even the Bible says don't reject wisdom.
That's why I call y'all a cult, though, because y'all feel like everybody has to agree with y'all.
No, you don't have to agree.
Y'all are never wrong about anything, though. That's impossible.
Thank you.
No, that's impossible.
Oh, you're saying
y'all
we are wrong about stuff. No, I mean, we've been wrong. JLP's been wrong about different things. Hake has been wrong. Go ahead.
Y'all will argue about the smallest things just so you don't have to admit that you're wrong about something. You and JLP, y'all the same, got the same, like, personality when it comes to not wanting to be wrong on anything.
No, I mean, you may be onto something there. I'm not sure. I kind of have a sense of what you mean. Like, we'll get hung up on something that they say. They make a side comment, and we pin them down on that comment, and the person doesn't want to admit they were lying or wrong or mistaken about that comment, and then it'll become a big argument. And so I understand that.
I
like it's
do
a,
that.
Yeah, that happens. But JLP is not against. JLP is not a prideful man. Like, he will admit where he's wrong.
Oh, yeah, right.
He doesn't like to get it wrong. And Hake, I don't know. I've admitted being wrong sometimes.
I haven't seen it. I like to see a clip of it.
Oh, I don't make clips of that.
Yeah, I know. It'll make you look bad.
I mean, it's just not entertaining. Sometimes,
man. Man, I forgot what I called for, man. You're talking
you said
all small talk.
Well, okay, one of the things was, should we celebrate the death of PDF files?
Oh, yeah, man. Y'all wrong for that, man. Like, you should, like, Breonna Taylor, y'all had no right to say she deserved it because she was with a drug dealer. Like, that was totally wrong.
Deserved
y'all didn't
it
hold
in
the
this,
cops.
Okay, well, deserved
y'all
it in
didn't
the
hold the cops accountable for what they did.
But I don't know what the cops necessarily really did wrong.
The way they handled it, they didn't go by their procedure. They did their own thing, you know?
How so?
Like I don't know all the legal work, but from what I've seen, they didn't follow procedure on how they entered the house and stuff like that. If they would have followed procedure, they wouldn't have been in there blindly shooting.
Okay, but what about what the blacks did wrong there in that instance? Like, her boyfriend at the time shot at cops, or maybe she shot at cops. I think it was her boyfriend, though, at the
time. Well, think about you, Hake. If you were in your house and somebody busted in, you didn't know who it was, you'd do the same thing.
I don't know what I would do, but that's a fair point in that a lot of people have, Asmador even called the show about it. Asmador from Texas. He said, but anyway, like, whatever you think of Asmador, he made the point that multiple people have shot at cops and they've not been charged because they thought that it was a home invasion. So in that sense, you may have a point, but they knocked and announced.
Not may have a point, man. That girl should still be living, man. It shouldn't have been like that. If they would have knocked on the door, we have a warrant.
They did knock on the door.
Come outside.
But hold on, they knocked on the door.
We have a warrant for your arrest. Come outside.
I don't know if it was for an arrest. I think it was for a search.
That guy wouldn't have came out shooting like that if they just didn't barge in, man.
They knocked. They knocked, man. I'm telling you, they knocked. That's the story.
Well, I'm going to have to go back and look at the video because they have the body cam footage, right?
I don't know. I never look at body cam footage. I don't, my tender heart can't take that violence.
That's the truth, man. Like the body cam footage has the truth.
Not the whole truth. But anyway,
yeah,
like
most of the truth.
It's accepted and widely reported that they knocked and announced, even though they had a no-knock warrant. And had they not knocked, maybe she would have been alive today.
So who opened the door for them when they came in and started shooting?
They broke the door. The door after nobody allowed them in or something.
Yeah,
like that.
Well, they shouldn't have did that.
Why not?
There you go.
Why not? Just tell me why not. I'm not saying they shouldn't or should. Why not?
If nobody answered the door, that means nobody's home.
No, it doesn't mean that.
That's what it should mean. That's what it should mean.
You know what?
They can catch him another day.
Asmador agrees with you, I think. He said, well, I don't know if he agrees with you, but he says a man's home is his castle, and the cops should not be allowed to be doing this stuff willy-nilly. But think
right.
about how bad it is in Louisville, Kentucky. Isn't there, like, a lot of crime and drug crime and stuff like that?
In pockets of
And
rules.
So, like, the worse the things get, the worse this stuff gets, the more militant the cops have an excuse to get. So the blacks
what was
being
the warrant for?
The blacks being so bad makes the cops have the excuse of violating our rights.
Blacks. It has to be the blacks.
Well, I mean, it's blacks. Those were blacks. It was black drug dealers.
Yeah,
you know?
but when you say blacks, there you go again, like you put.
Okay,
everybody
the worse the criminals get. The worse
Just
the criminals
them.
Get.
Just
Whites.
Say them.
Them. The worse they get. the worse the cops have to get. And it's, I don't like it either. You may well be right. It's a violation of their rights to their home.
It is, man. You can handle things.
But that's not a criticism of the police. That's a criticism of the whole system that allows this stuff. And it's a criticism of our culture.
No, man. Cops aren't like free from criticism and being wrong.
I'm
man.
Not saying that.
Like,
yeah.
Nobody holds them accountable. Even if they're wrong, they always find a way to wiggle out of being held accountable because it makes them look bad if they have cops that are convicted and everything like that. That's why you have to catch it on videotape 100% for them to be convicted. Otherwise, they always get the nod in every case.
You may be right. I mean,
right.
you want as a cop or an American, you want to be you want to be presumed innocent unless proven guilty. That's just being fair. And I get what you're saying about the cops. They're maybe overprotected in a lot of cases. But
most
so
cases,
the,
man, you
but
know
the,
that.
The blacks are getting away with crime like crazy, man. Anyway, we gotta end. Appreciate your call,
petty
man.
If it's petty crime, then oh well. Who cares about petty crime?
Broken windows policing. Day. All right, take care, man.
Selling weed is not a death sentence.
I know, but nobody's said it was. Bye, man. Take care.
Yeah, man.
Adios. Rick in Hampton, Virginia, had his thoughts on the Breonna Taylor case. I cannot get to you. Some super chats from Evil Israel. Oh, no, I already got that one. Lin Yen Shin says, I suspect the establishment is intentionally trying to lower overall testosterone of all peoples, specifically to make us all docile, but to cure us of sex drive, especially us blacks who have twice the testosterone of whites, whoa, and six times that of Asians, whoa. Evil Israel says, why do black men have bloodshot eyes after being with a lady? Mace. I don't know what that means, Evil Israel. A no-knock warrant, says King Alpha Nerd, is a search warrant authorizing police officers to enter certain premises without first knocking and announcing their presence or purpose prior to entering the premises. She brought that on herself, John. Get a life. Thank you, King Alpha Nerd. And you may disagree with the whole premise of no-knock warrants, but they had that. They had it. They had a no-knock warrant, but they knocked and announced for some reason. And now, guys, I know we're over time. Can we play this song? Let's play more Stephen Wiley, rated highly. This track is The Rock, I think. Indeed. Adios, America. Take care.
Highly. Wiley, let me talk to you. I'm gonna tell you the truth. You heard raps about life and raps about strife. Let me rap to you about Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the King who created everyone and everything. The Almighty Creator made and to flesh. He's the God of the universe at his best. He's the mastermind, Mr. Divine, the greatest one you will ever find. His intellectual capability, and he's the thought process of you and me. He's got all the power and all the might. He can speak and things will appear in sight. He's never sleepy, doesn't bat an eye. He's never tired, and this is why. He's magnificent, omnipotent. This man is definitely God sent. He's the gracious, righteous, holy Son, Jesus Christ. This man is number one. So hey, hey, he's a rock. He's a rock that won't roll. Hey, hey, Jesus is a rock, and he wants to save your soul. Hey, hey, he's a rock. He's a rock that won't roll. Hey, hey, Jesus is a rock, and he wants to save your soul. Now since you know where I'm coming from, I mean who he is and what he's done. And let me break it down so you can see what he's done for you personally. He knows who you are. He knows your name. This is reality, brother. This ain't no game. He died for you to give you life. He was the only one that could pay the price. They beat him, whipped him, spat on him too. He went through this all just for you. And then they nailed Jesus Christ on the cross. So my man died. They thought it was lost, but he came back to life. Jesus Christ, he's the boss. The boss. Hey, hey, he's a rock. He's a rock that won't roll. Hey, hey, Jesus is a rock. And he wants to save your soul. Hey, hey, he's a rock. He's a rock that won't roll. Hey, hey, Jesus is a rock. And he wants to save your soul. He's alive and ready to receive you as his own. Call him up, you don't need no telephone. He's right there ready to come in your heart. So listen closely and let's start. I'm gonna count to three. One, two, three. Now repeat this phrase after me. Jesus, I'm a sinner. And I know that you're the one. You came to take away my sins through your begotten Son. I believe you died and rose again, just like the scriptures say. So Jesus, forgive me of my sins and come live in my heart today. Hey, hey, he's a rock. He's a rock that won't roll. Hey, hey, Jesus is a rock. And he wants to save your soul. Hey, hey, he's a rock. He's a rock that won't roll. Hey, hey, Jesus is a rock. And he wants to save your soul. He's a rock, the rock, the rock that won't roll. The rock that wants to save your soul.